The owner of the vineyard went out and wanted to hire laborers to work in his vineyard. He went out at 6, 9, 12 noon, 3, and at the 11th hour at 5 p.m., he also hired some laborers to work in his vineyard. After working, he instructed his foreman to give the daily wage to those who came first, who came last. And surprisingly, the owner of the vineyard gave them the daily wage. And so those who were working for hours, those who came in early, were expecting that they would get more. And yet, surprisingly, they received the same daily wage as those who have only worked for an hour. And so they were disappointed and murmured. Pero anong sabi ng may-ari ng ubasan? Wala akong ginawang masama. I did nothing wrong to you. Take what is yours and go home. Ibig sabihin po na ayon sa nararapat ay ibinigay ng may-ari ng ubasan their daily wage. Pero hindi lang ayon sa nararapat ang ipinagkaloob ng may-ari ng ubasan, kundi mas higit pa, lalong-lalo na yung mga nagtrabaho lamang ng isang oras. Ano po ang mensahe ng ating ebanghelyo ngayong gabi? That the Lord does not deal with us in terms of justice, but He deals with us in terms of mercy and compassion. Alam nyo po, sa lumang tipan, ang ubasan ay simbolo ng Israel, ang bayang Israel, ang bayang pinili ng Diyos. Pero itong bayang pinili ng Diyos ay hindi lagi silang tapat. They were considered, if it were a vineyard, barren, dry, fruitless. But the Lord was patient with Israel like a vineyard. He enriched the soil. He developed the soil. Made it fruitful. Because the Lord is merciful. The Lord is faithful. Napakaganda po ang mensahe sa lumang tipan na nangyari sa buhay ni Propeta Hosea. Si Propeta Hosea ay nagkaroon ng asawa na hindi tapat sa kanya. Siya'y nangangaliwa. In fact, she bore 3 kids from other men. At ano ang tinanong ni Hosea, Prophet Hosea, sa Panginoon? Panginoon, anong gagawin ko sa aking misis? Nagtataksil at sumasama sa ibang lalaki, very, very unfaithful, a prostitute at that. Ano ang sabi ng Panginoon kay Propeta Hosea? Forgive your wife, Hosea. Take back your wife, even though she is unworthy of your love. At tanong ng Propeta Hosea, Panginoon, ano bang aral ang gusto mong ipahiwatig sa akin, sa aking karanasan? And the Lord answered Prophet Hosea, you know, Prophet Hosea, he said, I'm just like you. And my people, the Israelites, are like your wife, Gomer. She's very unfaithful. But every time My people, the Israelites, are unfaithful. They sin against me. They are very unfaithful. I always take them back. I always forgive them. That is mercy. That is compassion. That's why the psalmist says, the Lord does not deal with us according to what our sins deserve, but He deals with us in mercy and compassion. And that is exactly what the owner of the vineyard told the laborers, are you envious because I am generous? Ipinagkaloob ko sa inyo ang nararapat, but beyond that, I am compassionate, I am merciful. Kaya hindi po nakapagtataka na sa isang okasyon, sinabi ng Panginoon Jesucristo, unless you become like little children, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Alam niyo po sa tradisyon ng mga Romano, at mayroon ding impluensya ito sa mga Hudyo, the father, the Roman father, has absolute power over the newly born child. Kapag sinabi ng tatay na ayaw niya, then they have to do away with the child. In the same way, in the Jewish culture, children have no rights. They were considered as second-class citizens. They cannot demand anything. Ang mga bata, they are playful. They are carefree. No worries because they are totally dependent on their parents or their benefactors. Whereas tayong mga matatanda, adults, we are expected to work, we are expected to deliver. And so, after 15 days or after 30 days, we demand our wage, our salary. Alam niyo po yung salitang salary ay galing sa Latin, sal, ibig sabihin asin. Sapagkat noong unang panahon, ang binibigay na sahod sa mga nagtatrabaho ay asin, salt, salary. Kaya nga meron tayong kasabihan na kapag ikaw ay tamad, sinasabi sa iyo, you are not worth your salt, you are not worth your salary. If you work hard, you can demand, no, your salary because it is due you. Kagaya ng mga nagtatrabaho sa ubasan, pinagkaloob ng may-ari ng ubasan ang kanilang sahod na nararapat. Kung gusto mong ma-promote, dapat ikaw ay magpakitang gilas, magtrabaho ng maayos. That's the world of the adults, the serious world. In our relationship with God, we are not adults, as it were. We cannot demand anything from God. In fact, we cannot win over God's mercy, even though we do not deserve it. It is freely given. We can never win, we can never work for God's mercy and compassion because it is freely given. We cannot demand or win God's favor. We do not deserve it, and yet it is freely given. Kaya, sinasabi ng Panginoon Jesucristo, in your relationship with God, you should be like children, carefree, worry-free, playful, no worries, because your Heavenly Father knows what you need even before you utter them. He makes His sunshine on the good and the bad. He makes His rainfall on the righteous and the unrighteous. And Saint Paul was even more emphatic when he said, even when we were yet sinners, Christ died on the cross. And so what is our response to to the parable that we have heard tonight, to be generous as our Heavenly Father is generous, to be compassionate as our Heavenly Father is compassionate, as it were, going the extra mile, overcoming evil with good. Kaya nga sa Luke 6, 27-36, Jesus has several teachings which somehow show us what it means to be going the extra mile. So Jesus said, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, and pray for those who mistreat you. Give to the one who asks, and if anyone has taken something from you, do not demand it back. Do to others as you would have others do to you. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and it will be given back to you in full measure. Siksik, liglig, at umaapaw ang gantimpalang ipagkakaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. At sabi niya, if you do this, then your reward will be great. You will be called sons and daughters of the Most High. To sum up all these teachings, Jesus says, be merciful just as your Father is merciful.